U.S.-Pakistan ties are at an all-time low and anti-Americanism in Pakistan at an all-time high. And the media in Pakistan plays a role in whipping up this anti-Americanism. To understand what role the media plays in society and in anti-Americanism, I have one of the most well-known Pakistani journalists with me, Najam Sethi, the founding editor of Daily Times, as well as currently the editor-in-chief of the political weekly Friday Times. Najam, where does this anti-Americanism in the Pakistani media come from?
Well, there are two sources of anti-Americanism. The first source is American policies in Pakistan, starting in 1989, when America cut off all aid, tried to turn Pakistan's nuclear program back, sanctioned Pakistan, and then refused to give Pakistan the F-16s or the money back and so on. So there are American policies that turned Pakistan and Pakistanis against America. And then the new dimension to that has been added by this war on terror. Originally it began as America's war on terror, and then it became Pakistan's war on terror, because we've lost nearly 30,000 people killed. The Taliban have turned against us for helping America. And what has Pakistan got in return?
So what does then this mean going forward for the U.S.-Pakistan strategic relationship?
Well, there is no strategic relationship. And I think there never was a strategic relationship. This was, both sides pretended that there was a strategic relationship because it sounded good. It was always a transactional relationship. The Pakistanis certainly saw it as a transactional relationship. What are we getting out of it? This is not our war. We're going to help the Americans. The American attitude was, yeah, it's not your war, it's our war. This is what we're going to give you and we need your cooperation. Now, unfortunately, because we now have a Taliban turned against Pakistan, this has become our war also. And because it's become our war, not just America's war, we have now acquired strategic differences with America on how to deal with the issue. And therefore, where it should become a strategic relationship, the transactional relationship is broken down because the carrots are not working. The strategic relationship is yet to be born because neither side is putting its cards on the table. The Americans are not prepared to look at Pakistan's national security interests in Afghanistan. The Pakistanis are not prepared to yield to American national security interests in Afghanistan. That's where the deadlock is.
If we could take a step back just to understand, what is the media climate like in Pakistan? How free then is the media, which is obviously, you know, burgeoning? And what, you know, the tone differences there might be between English language press and the Urdu press and the other regional languages press?
Well, you know, the thing is, the Pakistani media is very, very free. There are no restrictions of any kind. There are laws to restrict the media, you know, media freedoms, where my freedom impinges on your freedom, libel, defamation and so on. But the courts are very weak and the courts are not ready to take on the media. The courts feel indebted to the media for having restored the courts to a position of independence vis-a-vis the executive. So the media really is so free, it's unbelievable. It can get away with murder, and there's no one to challenge it. Governments are too weak to challenge it. The military tries to manipulate it. Beyond a point, it fails because the media is a work in progress, and there are very fiercely independent commentators as well. So the media is free. In terms of the freedom of the media, the anti-American narrative, the anti-India narrative runs much more fiercely in the Urdu vernacular media. For two reasons. First of all, that's where the public is educated. The textbooks are all full of revisionist history and a national security paradigm. Secondly, the Islamist dialogue was thrust on the education system, and many people in the current media are products of that educational system. The third factor is that the English media is far more liberal, far more rational, far more oriented to debate and discussion and pragmatism. But unfortunately, English is still not a second language in Pakistan. Maybe the total circulation of the entire English print media is less than 100,000. Or maybe there are, what, at best, 500,000 English speakers and readers. Well, speakers many more, of course, but readers. So the English media is not making an impact in terms of the good things that it is saying.
You say the media is free, yet we see journalists being murdered, journalists being kidnapped. So what does this freedom really mean?
The media is under attack from two sources. It's not under attack from the government of the day, nor indeed the political opposition of the day. This is a remarkable fact. Most medias in different countries come under attacks from established organs of the state. In our case, the media is fearful of non-state actors. Pakistan is replete, awash with non-state actors. There are jihadi groups, there are sectarian groups, there are ethnic groups, some of which are patronized by the national security establishment for various reasons, but therefore have acquired a degree of autonomy and semi-legitimacy. These are all armed groups. It's very difficult for the media to speak out against them because there's no protection from the state against these groups. As I said, some of these groups are on the hit list of the state, like the sectarian groups, but the state is incapable of dealing with them. The state apparatuses are so weak that they can't take on any of these groups, so they get away with murder. And then, of course, there are those groups which were originally part of the jihad, which was sponsored by the state, and now are used for various invisible ends. They are intolerant of people who criticize jihad, or people who are seen to be pragmatic, or people who are in any way seen to undermine, quote-unquote, their definition of national security.
Najam, thank you so much for joining us today.
You're welcome.